soldiers in the army of the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. That got your blood moving on today. Hallelujah. We can be soldiers together. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Amen. We're grateful to God. He's been so good and so kind. Amen. We're going to open up with prayer and scripture, and then we will have the word of God from the man of God. Amen. We're just glad that God has blessed us to see another day, another day's journey, and I am so glad for another day's journey. God, today we thank you and we praise you for your many blessings. First of all, God, we thank you for watching over us as we slumbered and slept on last night. You kept the hands of death away from our door. You protected us in the midst of it all, and we want to thank you for that on today. We thank you for your loving kindness and your tender mercies that are new every morning. Your mercies are new every morning, and we thank you, Lord. And Lord, even now, so much is happening through the land. God, we need you to walk through the land. We need your spirit to reign even now. We need your spirit to shower down on the world even on today, God. All those tactics and all of the negative things that are going on, God. Lord, be in their hearts and minds and turn things around. Turn things around. Let them change that stony heart into a heart of flesh and love. Any of the tactics that are being used, God, Lord, you change it and turn it around even on today. And God, those that are sick, whether they're sick with COVID, whether they're sick with hypertension, whether they're sick with diabetes, whether they're sick with cancer, God, touch their bodies right now. From the crown of their head to the soles of their feet, those that are crying out for healing on today, Lord, hear their prayer. Hear their cry even now. Those that are in the hospital, God. Doctors may not know what's going on, but you know what's going on. You know every head that hair that's on their head. You know every part of their DNA. God, go there. Be there. Help them even now in the hospitals. Those that are in their homes, God, touch them right now in the mighty name of Jesus. They can be laying in the bed racking with pain. Touch their bodies right now. Touch their joints right now. Touch the muscles even now. Touch them in the mighty name of Jesus. And those that are confused today, those that are depressed today, touch their minds even now. Bring that mind back in, God. Let them know that you're there. Let them know that everything will be all right. And God, our children all throughout the land, touch them right now. Touch their minds as they study virtually, and some that are going back to school on tomorrow. Put a fence of protection around them right now, God. Protect the children. And Lord, touch all the teachers even now. Give them the correct lesson plan for the children. Give them innovative ways to help the children to learn even now. And then give them patience. Patience to deal with whatever situation they are dealing with today. And God, we thank you for this even now. And Lord, let your anointing reign. Let it reign in this building as never before. Lord, let a new thing happen even now. We're a waiting congregation for you to sweep through even on today. Let your spirit reign. Hallelujah. Touch your manservant from the crown of his head to the sole of his feet. Anoint him as never before, God, and bless him even now. And God, we're going to be careful to give you all the honor and glory that you deserve because you have been good. Amen and amen. Psalms 21 says, "The king shall joy in thy strength, Lord, and in thy salvation, how greatly shall he rejoice." Amen. That is our scripture today. Psalms 21 and 1. We're going to greatly rejoice in him. Hallelujah. Yes, we get joy when we think about what he's done. Amen. If we were to have testimony service even now, it'd be going on for hours for so many people telling the goodness of God. Because he's been so good and so kind. And he's watched over and protected us from dangers, seen and unseen. My mother used to pray that prayer, "Lord, protect us as we go. Protect us from danger seen and unseen." Glory be to God. Amen. We're so glad you tuned in with Elmwood Memorial on today to our worship service, our noon worship service on today. We love you and we appreciate you, and as well as when you share it with others. Continue to share the page. Continue to let others know that Elmwood Memorial is here, and we are spreading the word of God to as many people as we possibly can. And that we have no other motive but to share the word of God with one another, so that somebody will cause somebody to give their life to Christ. Because it's all about the souls. Glory be to God. And we're grateful to God for our members. We're grateful to God for everyone in their respective places. We're grateful to those who have given to this church. You have helped us. We thank you for helping us to keep our church sustained. Even in the midst of this pandemic, we're able to keep our church sustained. All of our bills are paid. Everything is taken care of. Our lights are still on. Our water still works. The heat is even on. Glory be to God. We thank you for everything that you have given to support this ministry. And know that anything that is given to the church. It is for the upkeeping of the church and the kingdom of God. You can do so if you would like to give by Givelify. Please go to Elmwood Memorial Church of God in Christ. You will see a photo of the church as well as a photo of the pastor. Or you can use Cash App, and that is $BenitaBuck01. And I will put that down in the comments for you even on today. And you may say, I don't have Cash App and I don't know how to use Givelify. Get that 55-cent stamp and put it in the mail and mail it to 5048 Dr. Martin Luther King, St. Louis, Missouri, 63113. And know that every dollar that comes into this church is used for this ministry in this church. So we're grateful to God for that even on today. Also, as a reminder, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday is a prayer at sundown at 6 o'clock p.m. And we want everybody to tune in, even on this week coming up. Glory be to God. And look for our videos. Whenever you see our videos, come on. Click on there and see what thus saith the Lord. Go back and look at the prayers. Go back and look at the messages that is there to encourage you and share it with others. Amen. Amen. I'm going to sing a short selection, and then you will be in the hands of our pastor, Pastor Donald Buckner. Great is your mercy towards me, your loving kindness towards me, your tender mercies I see day after day.
Great is your mercy toward. great in mercy. And his mercy is great. Amen. The song kind of personalizes it and says his grace and mercy is great towards me. Amen. I'm grateful tonight, today, that our God has great mercy that he extends toward us. Amen. We are grateful again to be able to come to you on today and to be able to share in the word, and glad that you have taken time to share with us in our services. Amen. It is great that you are able to be here. We know that there are many other places that you could tune to, but I think it's an honor that you chose to tune in here on today. And I'm just grateful for you. We're grateful to God, amen, who is the head of our life. We're thanking God for salvation and for the gift of the Holy Ghost. We thank and praise God just for all who are here. Amen. First Lady, who was here with us on today, is carrying the service on to this point. And we are grateful to her, amen, as well as the Sunday school that she did on today. We're thankful to God. Amen. We're thanking and praise God for, amen, Brother Lucas Brown being with us again on today. Amen. Sharing with us in his music ministry. Amen. Helps to booster the service. Amen. I'm grateful to him for being here with us. Amen. A great asset, I would say, to this ministry. Amen. God bless Mother Childs being with us today. Amen. So good to see you here. Amen. With us here in service today. Amen. We're going to go to the word of the Lord on today. Amen. I don't have a long message today, but I believe I have a message that will encourage us all. Amen. In the midst of what we are yet going through and yet dealing with. Amen. So God, we thank you and we praise you on this day. We thank you for how you continuously watched over us, how you kept us up until this present time. We thank you, dear God, because we know that without you we can do nothing, but we know with you we can do all things. So even on today, God, as people are tuned in even now and they're listening, oh God, ready for to hear a word from you, Lord, I would pray that you would yet, God, send forth your word, that you would speak on today, Lord, not me, because I have nothing, oh God, that would be able to change anybody. But Lord, your word changes, oh God. Your word can change, oh God. Just one word from you can change our life. It can change a situation. It can change everything, oh God, is going on. So Lord, I pray you would yet speak your word to those, oh God, who are here. Speak to us, oh God, that we might do what you would have us to do. And Lord, I pray you would yet anoint me the more, God. Oh God, anoint me to speak, oh God, as you would have me to speak and to share the word as you would have me to share it on today. And Lord, we thank you and we give you all the praise. We're going to glorify you even right now for what you're doing. In Jesus' name we pray, thank God. Amen and amen. Amen. Once again, we are grateful to God and we're getting ready to go into the Word. And as I mentioned, we're not going to be before you very long. Amen. I do want to make emphasis on the announcement that was just given regarding the prayer on this week. Amen. We are going into a time, amen, I believe, where certain things are happening within this world, and within our nation, even within our churches. Amen. And I believe that it, of course, we always know that prayer is always in order.
Yes.
And so the Lord impressed upon me that we would, on these three nights of this week, which are Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, that we would set aside a time and have what I'm calling, categorizing as a prayer revival. Amen. We're going to be doing that over Facebook. Amen, as well as through our conference line. Amen, we're going to have people, and we'll be giving you those more information on that, I should say, later this evening. We'll be sharing more information about the prayer revival that will take place on this Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday at 6 o'clock p.m. nightly. And you want to be a part of that. I believe it's going to be a life-changing, amen, prayer revival that will take place on this week.
Yes.
Amen, so we're looking forward to that. Amen. On today, this morning, amen, we're going to the book of Haggai, the second chapter, and we're going to be reading verses 4 through 8. That's Haggai, the second chapter, verses 4 through 8. Again, I'm not going to be before you too long, but I sure hope that you get something out of this on today. And it says here, "Yet now be strong, O Zerubbabel, saith the Lord, and be strong, O Joshua, son of Josedech, the high priest. And be strong, all ye people of the land, saith the Lord, and work. For I am with you, saith the Lord of hosts."
Yes.
"According to the word that I covenanted with you when you came out of Egypt, So my spirit remaineth among you. Fear ye not. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once it is a little while, and I will shake the heavens and the earth and the sea and the dry land. And I will shake all nations, and the desire of all nations shall come. And I will fill this house with glory, saith the Lord of hosts. The silver is mine, and the gold is mine, saith the Lord of hosts. We're going to take, if you will, our thought from verse number 6, where it says, for thus saith the Lord of hosts, yet once it is a little while, and I will shake the heavens and the earth and the sea and the dry land. And I will shake all nations, and the desire of all nations shall come. And I will fill this house with glory, saith the Lord of hosts. Now I'm going to talk today from a subject here, amen, that I believe will help you on today, that I think all of us can say I agree with you on today, Pastor. Subject today is there's a whole lot of shaking going on. Yeah, there's a whole lot of shaking going on. Amen. I think all of us can look throughout this year. And I believe, I know that there's many different things people are saying, you know, this is the year of abnormality, this is the year of the pandemic, this is the year of doing things different, this is the year of putting things on hold, this is the year of not planning because you can't do anything right through now. So, you know, they would say all kinds of things, but in the spirit realm, I just hear just a whole lot of shaking going on. And I say it like that because I put it in the Bible context, amen, because when I hear all these other things, when I hear about this is the year of abnormality, or this is the year when you really can't plan anything, or this is the year when looked like that we had stuff together and was ready to go, and then we all of a sudden were put on hold. We were just stopped, and you know, year of trying to do things differently, and year of trying to make stuff happen. You know, sometimes they say, sometimes you just have to let things happen. But we've been trying to make something happen. Look like the more we try, amen, and look like sometimes the more we try, look like the less things begin to occur. It looks like, as I said before and said it again, that looked like that when we first kind of went into this, we thought it would only be a little bit of a short time, and then we would be out of it. Amen. And then looking at all of it, amen, someone would say, well, what does that really have? You know, how is that really any spirituality in any of those things that we just said? Well, when I read this here, I said, when I began to read and thought about this even on last night, late last night, it came to me, amen, that there's just a whole lot of shaking going on. Amen. When you look at everything, it's a lot of shaking going on. When you look at what's going on in this earth, you have to say, amen, I mentioned before when all of this kind of started, I said, there must be something going on up in heaven. There's some things going on in heaven. There's a whole lot, and a lot of what we're kind of getting, if you will, is almost the aftershock or almost like the after effects of what's happening in heaven. I believe that the devil is really making himself known, if you will, and I believe that there's a lot, that there's war that is going on, and I believe what we are feeling are the shocks of that, and that's why I just said that there's a whole lot of shaking going on. There's shaking going on in heaven. But I want you to know, and the reason why I chose this subject, why the Lord gave it to me, is because when you read all of this, you will the overlapping thing that you'll get out of this is that God is still in control. While there's shaking going on, God is still in control, amen, of everything that is happening. Yes. And I want you to know that, first of all, as I said before, this may have caught all of us by surprise. I don't think when we turned the pages and moved into the year of 2020 that anybody had in their mind this was what was going to be taking place. Right. And I believe there were many people, amen, I believe almost, I would say a majority of people, amen, unless you had a really, really good intuitive thing about yourself, amen, really, amen, did not expect this to happen. But I want you to know that, first of all, nothing happens that God is not aware of. God already knew this was going to happen. He already knew this was going to take place. Amen. But yet and still, I'm letting you know it because he knew it was all going to take place. He is yet in control. All right. He's not lost control. Amen. Even though there's shaking going on, we've not shaken God's hand loose. Amen. From being in control of what's happening. You know, sometimes when things shake, if you know, sometimes if you have like, I think about, you know, when you build things, and if you have like, you know, bolts and nails and everything that may be in the walls and holding things together. And sometimes when you get a good shaking, if you will, of that wall, sometimes those things that are holding that thing together will begin to rock. It will begin to reel. It will begin, if you will, to separate. Next thing you know, that thing that was holding together all of a sudden has broken. Whatever it was that was being held together has fallen apart. But I want you to know that our God, amen, who is holding things together right now, that even with all of this shaking going on, amen, whatever it is, if it's of God, amen, it's not going to fall apart. Right. God yet has his hand, amen. God is yet holding this thing together. But I yet want you to know that there's a lot of shaking that is going on. And as I said, amen, this has not caught God by surprise. Amen. This is nothing new, as I said to him. But the scripture does say that there is nothing new under the sun. Amen. There's nothing new, amen, when it comes to this sort of thing. I know it may be new to us. I know it may be new, the fact we're going through this different type of situation. But I want you to know that God has already been through this. Matter of fact, when I believe, when he actually created the heavens and the earth, he already knew this was going to happen. He was already in this here. And I believe, just like our God is a God of provision, I believe God already had a way out for us. And I already believe that before this thing came, the way was already made for us to make it through. Amen. I know we are yet going through this, and I know it seems like it's been a long time. But I want you to know that God yet has provided a way for us to make it through. Amen. I can say that, amen, because I know he's brought us through other things. And I can also say it because of the fact that we are yet here, amen, as a testimony that in the midst of this pandemic, we are yet here. Amen. But I'm letting you know today there's a whole lot of shaking that's going on. Amen. It's shaking in the heavens. It's shaking going on here in the earth. Shaking going on in our government. Shaking going on and even in our homes. Shaking going on in our churches. There's a lot of shaking that is going on. We must understand that in the midst of this, amen, when there is some shaking that goes on, sometimes there are some things that are just going to fall off. All right. Mother, there's some things that's just going to, it's not going to, you know, some things are not going to survive the shake. All right. Some things are not going to make it through the shake. Some things just are not going to make it through. So we're going to have to learn, amen, that when the shaking is over, oh my God, yeah, when the shaking is over, amen, our question is going to be, are you going to be able to stand? Uh-huh. When the shaking is all done, will we be able to stand? Will we be the ones that will testify and say, when the shaking was going on, we may have rocked and reeled a little bit, but I'm yet standing. When the shaking is over, I'm yet standing here today. Glory be to God. And I know for many of us, amen, I want you to know, even on today, that I believe that many people had, amen, if you will, the same situation, I believe, that was going on back when Haggai, amen, prophesied here. We had here, I believe, at a time when the Babylonian captivity had taken place. And you all know that in the captivity of Babylon, you had prophets who prophesied prior to that, and some who came along after that. Amen. Haggai came along after that. Thus, he was named a minor prophet. He came along, and when he came along, you had, after the Babylonian captivity had taken place, you had, amen, a remnant of people. And I want to let you know, amen, that sometimes when things go on, when there are big things that happen, and if you will, in history, you can look and see that sometimes, amen, the church sometimes, you know, gets shooken just a little bit. It gets stirred a little bit. Sometimes things can happen, and sometimes you'll see, well, the Bible even tells it that in this day and time, there's going to be a great falling away. But there's yet going to be some people who are yet not going to bow down, amen, to the devil. And so here, there's always going to be a remnant. And so here you had, when the Babylonian captivity took place, amen, the place that was known as Solomon's Temple. That place, amen, that was built, that God had allowed Solomon to build, amen, had fallen down, amen, in the midst of this captivity. So here you had people who had a mind that said, I'm going to go and I'm going to work. And we're going to work and we're going to rebuild a temple. We're going to build something for our Lord and for God. And so they began, if you will, to build. And while they began to build, amen, with this residue of people, Haggai came and he said, I got a question for you all.
I didn't read this here, but my mother, but in the beginning, you all know how the story, when he said, who is it that's left among you that saw this house in her first glory? Yeah, the first glory. You know the first glory of the house that Solomon built. When Solomon built that house, amen, he had what I call a dedication service. He got ready to dedicate that place to God. And he called all the people together when he had finished. And I want you to know that when Solomon built his house, and that's why, and I believe that we all ought to take a little lesson out of this. When Solomon built the house of God, he didn't spare any expense with that. Amen. He didn't cut any corners.
Right.
But he put everything in there. He made everything, amen, perfect. Amen. He knew that he was not building something, if you will, for you or I to live in. But he was building a house of God. And he knew that God was the one who had made everything. And that God was and is our everything.
Yes.
And because God has done so much for us, I couldn't just go and get some, you know, some raggedy, you know, material. I couldn't go and get secondhand stuff off of me. I had to go and get, you know, the very best, amen, because that's how our God is. God gives us the very best.
Yes.
And I know many people, maybe you don't even understand me, that this is one part about me when it comes sometimes to my house, amen. Sometimes I may go, mother, and I may get some secondhand stuff. And I may just try to, you know, if we'll kind of get it together. But when it comes to the house of the Lord, I can't go and get secondhand stuff because my God is not a secondhand God. Thank God for Jesus. So I do the very best that I can to give God the very best, amen, when it comes to his place. So here he says, the question comes, how did you see it in his first glory? Well, when the first glory, it worked like this, that when they got ready to dedicate the temple, amen, Solomon began to pray unto God. And wanted to know, God, will your glory yet be in this place? And I heard that when they got ready to go into the place, they got ready to open the door. When they opened up the door, they saw the glory cloud was yet down there inside in the temple. My God, that was God's glory resting on that place. And I believe that when they began to be now at a point where the temple now has been destroyed, I believe they said, now are we going to build something else? We want to construct something. We know how we're supposed to go about it. And so then Joshua and then they began to build. And they were out there working. And so God sends forth Haggai to talk unto them. And he began to share with himself, I got news for you. You all are doing a good work. And I want you to know that God is yet with you in your working. And some of you may have started out this year and said in your heart, I'm going to be more faithful to the Lord. I'm going to come to church more often. I'm going to participate in Bible study and in prayer meeting. I'm going to make my way to Sunday school more often. And then all of a sudden, amen, things began to happen. Why? Because there was some shaking that was going on that somehow prohibited you from moving on forward. But God is speaking to you on today and telling you to keep on working. Don't you stop doing whatever it is that you were doing. Don't stop with your dedication, but keep on coming on to the Lord. He said, I want you to know that the Lord is yet with you. And he said, the heck, I said, this is not me talking, but this is God talking to you, telling you that I am yet with you. But he said, I want you to understand that there is something that's getting ready to happen. He said, God is getting ready to shake some stuff. And I got news for you. God is yet shaking stuff today. He's shaking stuff in our government. How many of you can look and see? Oh, my God. I don't mean to talk here in this way, but this is just as an example. That I know that many times we're talking about our country and we're looking at the division that is taking place. We're seeing almost one side of a radical side, another side of a radical side. Two sides don't like one another. Almost if you're not careful, if we aren't careful, we'll find ourselves in another civil war. And here they are, we look like they are all divided. But this week when our leader got sick and had to go into the hospital, everybody started sending stuff in, praying for him. Folk probably didn't even know how to pray. Was talking about, we praying for you today. Folk didn't matter what side they were on. Was talking about, we praying for our leader. Somebody said, what's going on? I said, there's some shaking going on. God is trying to shake some stuff up here. God is shaking some things loose here. Thank you, Jesus. He said here in his word that I will shake all the nations. My God, today, I want you to know that when that happened, you had leaders from other countries that were looking over here and are yet watching and seeing what's going to happen to our leader, the President of the United States. But I got news for you, as saints of God, that the shaking may be going on. And I want to tell you something else here. I'm going to let you know right now that God is not through shaking. There's going to be some more shaking going on. But I'm going to tell you, just like this, if you hold on to Jesus, if you hold on to God while the shaking is going on, when the shaking ends, you will yet be standing. God is telling us today to hold on to him. Hold on in the midst of the shaking. You got to hang on in there. Makes no difference which way this world goes. The world is going to rock. The world is going to reel. The world's going to throw its hands up and say, what we going to do? The reason they're throwing their hands up is because they're shaking going on. And their very foundations that they call themselves standing on is going to be shaken. What are you talking about, preacher? Look at the economy. God is going to shake the economy. And some folk who are relying on their money, look at their 401ks. At their stock market, look at their investments. God is yet saying, I'm going to shake it up, and it's going to come a time they're going to call themselves trying to find something to stand on, and it won't be there. But that's why I'm telling you, you better get a hold. Get a hold to Jesus. Stand on that solid rock, because when the shaking goes on, you won't be shooken. You won't be stirred, but you'll be able to hang in there. And I want you to know, as I get out of here and make my getaway, and I told you before that this is nothing new about some shaking going on. Because when God prophesied unto these people, he told them, I know what you want, to use the very best to make up this household. He said, but I want you to know something, that the gold, it belongs to me. The silver, it belongs to me. Don't you think like I said it before, and I'll say it again. I'm grateful to you, the gift of this ministry. And I want you to know something. As was mentioned before, it's all used to the upbuilding of God's kingdom. But I want you to know something here. Don't you get in your head that you've done something so big, you've done something so grand. God is yet saying that the silver is yet mine and the gold is yet mine. If you make up in your mind and in your heart and say, I'm not going to give the old church another dime in my life, I want you to know that God will open up the hands of someone else. God will not leave his church unattended. Thank you, Jesus. But I want you to know that he is familiar with some shakeups. Because I want you to know that there was a time in the Bible when the heavens and the earth and everything under the earth went through a shaking. And that was the time when God sent his son, Jesus Christ. And when he died upon the cross, the Bible said that the earth began to shake. Heaven began to shake. Hell began to shake. Because the Son of God was on the cross giving his life for his friend. Yes. But before he went to the cross, he had already talked to the disciples. I believe he told them to let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. I believe he told him just a little while and everything is going to be shaken up. Things are going to be stirred up. in this earth. But if you yet hold on, if you can yet believe that I am the way, believe that I am the truth, believe that I am the life, believe that I am the foundation. If you believe on me, glory to God, nothing will happen to you. And I hear them even saying right now that you right now are looking at the shaking going on. You're concerned about your life. Oh God. But I hear him saying in his word that if you believe on me, and the scriptures have said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. Yes, I'm so glad in the midst of shaking that God can provide living water. Living water to my soul. Keeps me alive. Keep me smiling. While things are shaking, you can yet go through. Matter of fact, take an example. Take a page out of the New Testament. Look at Paul and Silas. When they caused some shaking. My God, today, when they were sitting down, when they had been locked up in prison, my God, they were being persecuted. Yes, they were. And they made up their mind in the midst of persecution. A day is about over. They had been beaten all day. Yes, they had been falsely accused, thrown in jail, waiting on death, I believe, to come. But while they were there, laid there bound up, they made up their mind. I believe they read back and said, you know what? There's been times when God has shaken this earth. There shouldn't be nothing for God to shake this prison. And I heard them at midnight. They didn't look back. They looked on back over their lives. Looked back over this day when they had been beaten, when they had been falsely accused, when they had been arrested. And instead of complaining, instead of murmuring, they began to give God some praise. And I want to tell you today that many of us, we have things that are holding us back. We got things that are preventing us from moving forward in God. And I hear God saying, if you give me some praise, if you give me some glory, I'll shake some things loose. I'll shake those things loose that are holding you down. Yes, I will. Yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. A shakedown. Things. Oh, my God. A shakedown. That's what we're going through. My God. A lot of things shaking. A lot of shaking. A lot of shaking going on. Mother, some of these things we didn't cause. But he says here, the Lord says here, I'm the one. Haggai said, he said the Lord was going to be the one to cause this shaking. You want to know where this stuff coming from? God is shaking this stuff up. That's all that's happening. God is shaking things up. And again, I say to you on today, you need to get a hold and stand on a firm foundation.
Yes.
In the midst of all of this shaking. If you aren't careful, if you're on the wrong foundation, oh my God, if you're on the wrong foundation, you're going to fall. But you want to make sure in the midst of all of this, as I said before, you're seeing now our world is reeling right now. They're shaking right now. They don't know how they're going to be able to hold things together. If you watched it, man, I know many of you watched. We're not oblivious. You saw when they took the president away. One of the first questions they had was, going to be a transfer of power. Who's going to be in control? Who's going to run our government? We're seeing other people in the government getting sick. And folk are wondering, who's going to run? I said to myself, God, I'm running it all the time. That's who's going to run it. God's going to run it. But if you don't have that assurance in your life, if you don't know that, that would have shaken you up. Uh-huh. I'm just telling you, there's going to be some shaking going on. It's a whole lot of shaking going on. And it's going to continue. I'm saying today, you need to get to know the Lord. You need to get to know him in your life. Because some of these shakings that are going on is going to cause things, if you're not careful, to happen even in your life. You better make sure that God, amen, is in your life. Make sure you're standing on his foundation. Make sure it's him
that's holding things together for you. And if he is, no matter what's going on, no matter how much shaking happens, if God is holding together, it's going to stay together. No matter what shaking happens. I want you to know also, people are concerned, and I thought about this, was a part of the message, let me just bring this out to you. Because I want you to know something, when the shaking stopped, when our Lord and Savior got out the ground, one of his first messages to the people, to his people, was to fear not. That was the message he sent through the angel. Fear not. What? Fear not. He is risen. He is not here. He's not here, but he's risen. But fear not. The shaking stopped. Fear not. So I'm saying to you, even on today, when the shaking is over, or even I should say while the shaking is going on, the Lord is saying, fear not. And when the shaking is over, he's yet going to be saying, fear not. Glory be to God. Why? Because God is in control. He's in control of everything that's going on. God bless you today. Amen. On today, I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you today that, as I say all the time, your faith don't fail you in the midst of this. Right. I'm praying that you'll be able to hold on in the midst of this shaking. Yeah. Amen. God, we thank you. We praise you today for this message, oh God. We thank you, God, for knowing, first of all, that you are in control. And because you're in control, it makes no difference what happens. It makes no difference how much shaking goes on. We know that in the end, God, that we are going to be able to stand. Because, God, you are in control. In the midst of the shaking that's taking place in the heaven, in the midst of the shaking that's taking place here in the earth, and in the midst of the shaking that's taking place under the earth, God, you are yet in control. And, God, I pray that you would yet give us to continue to work, continue to do what you have instructed us to do. Let us not go idly by. Let us not stand by and watch the shaking, but God, let us be found continuously doing your work that you have assigned to our hands to do. You said in your word, God, that we are to work, amen, while it is day. The night cometh when no man can work. You didn't quantify that by saying work while it's day as long as there's no shaking going on. But you said of us to work. So as long as we are here on this side of heaven, Lord, we pray that you would give us, oh God, a mind to continue on to work. Don't let us stop doing our work of spreading the gospel, letting people know that you, God, are yet the Savior of the world. And Lord, we know it's not just the preacher, because your word says that we are all ministers of reconciliation. We are to let the world know that they can be reconciled back to God. So God, help us to continue to do our work, oh God, that you have assigned to our hands. And God, we pray even in the midst, oh God, that you would give us not to be fearful in the midst of the shaking. But Lord, help us to continue on. And God, we're going to thank you right now and give you all the glory, all the praise, all the honor. Shall we, God, in Jesus' name, thank God. Amen, amen, amen. Before we go, there's someone maybe here, amen, watching today who was saying, my God, preacher, you're right, there's a lot of shaking going on. And I'm concerned about my life. I'm concerned about things going on in my family. I'm concerned about things happening on my job because there's shaking going on my job. There's shaking going on everywhere. Lord, I'm concerned. What can I do? Well, I can tell you that first of all, you need to give your life to the Lord. If you give your life to the Lord, amen, he will take care of the shaking, keep you in the midst of the shaking. As I mentioned before, this message, of course, is to the saints, that we are not to fear, we're not to worry, amen, while the shaking is going on. But if you don't know him, you need to get to know him. Then you'll be able to stand when the shaking is yet over. You don't want to be a part of the shakedown. You don't want to be a part of that. Amen. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. If you desire to be saved today, amen, that's the only way you're going to be able to make it through the shakedown, through the shaking that's going on. You've got to be saved. Simple, amen. The word tells us we can simply, it's there in our mouth. We can confess to him right now. The Lord Jesus, and believe in our heart that God has raised him from the dead. We can be saved. So even on today as we are here, we say, just repeat after me, just say, Lord Jesus, I thank you on today for how you have watched over me and how you have kept me. Lord Jesus, I pray today that you would save me. I believe that God sent you to die on the cross for my sins. And I today, Lord, ask you to forgive me of all sin that I have done. Lord Jesus, be the head of my life. And Lord Jesus, because of this confession, your word says that I am saved. And I accept you now. I accept salvation right now. If that's you, just begin to praise him right now and give him praise and glory even right now. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. Amen. We're getting ready to go at this time. And once again, remind you, this Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday, 6 o'clock p.m. will be our prayer revival that we're going to have. Amen. We're going to be praying at 6 o'clock p.m. each night on Facebook. Amen. Make sure you tune on Facebook Live as well as on our conference call line. We'll be coming through, amen, with prayer. Amen. At 6 o'clock p.m. will be our prayer revival. At this time, amen, we have a little time. Missionary Buck is going to come, give us a selection, take us off. Let's say amen for her as she comes.
Get right, church, and let's all go.